Should you buy a webcam or a camcorder? The three factors to consider are image quality, price, and convenience. Let's start with image quality. In these shots, I'm comparing the Canon Vixia HFR 800 camcorder to the Logitech C920 webcam and the Logitech Brio webcam. The Vixia records 1080p 60 frames per second, the C920 does 1080 30, and the Brio does 1080 60 and 4K 30. On the camcorder, the noisy image, all that static, and the softness of the footage is super distracting compared to the webcams. If you're recording inside and daylight is your only light source, then the Brio is gonna be the best choice. When recording in daylight and studio lighting, you can get away with the Logitech C920, but the Vixia still doesn't quite match up. Most camcorders are really made to be used outdoors in a lot of light. And for the Vixia, that's where this does its best. I'll talk more about outdoors in the convenience section of this comparison. At night, you'll definitely need a good lighting kit to get a good image out of either a camcorder or a webcam. I have a few lighting reviews and lighting tips videos where I talk about the lights I use. But even with basically an artificial sun in my room, I literally have 5 different lights around me right now. Even with all that, I couldn't get the Canon Vixia to match the C920's quality, and definitely not the Brio. A very overlooked factor of camera quality is settings. Camcorders are notorious for having very limited manual settings. This one is no different. Now, none of these let you get really advanced settings like changing aperture size, shutter speed, or outright swapping lenses, but the settings you can change in your streaming software like OBS on the C920 and Brio can buff up your image way more than the settings on the Vixia. Another factor to consider is price. Can you get camcorders that look better than this one? Yeah. But can you get camcorders that look better than this and cost less than this at $250? Probably not. I bought this Logitech C920 for $50, pre-apocalypse, and the Logitech Brio for $150. But even at inflated prices, the C920 still looks just as sharp and often sharper than the camcorder for way less money. And the Brio shuts out both of these when it comes to image quality. Now for convenience or ease of use. This is where the camcorder wins. Mostly. Webcams are small and compact, but you have to connect them to a USB port on a computer for them to work. Camcorders you can put in your bag, pocket, whip it out to take shots, or carry around with you while you vlog, and you can save all of your footage to an SD card. Both camcorders and webcams can be used to stream to Twitch, Zoom, YouTube, or whatever. Though with the camcorder, you're also going to have to buy a capture card, which is going to cost more money, and you'll need to make sure that that camcorder has a clean HDMI out. This one in particular does have clean HDMI out. And I'll also link my guide on how to set up streaming for camcorders. So my verdict should be pretty clear. If you're in the market for a camera that you can use inside, mostly for talking head videos, and you're willing to spend about $250, you can actually spend a lot less and get something that looks way better indoors, like the Logitech Brio. You can also get the Logitech C920. The Logitech C920 is a little bit sharper when you're recording video than the Canon Vixia HFR 800. It's quite a bit dimmer than the Brio. The Brio is way better when there is indoor lighting. Now, the Canon Vixia HFR 800 does take some decent shots outdoors if you have like a lot of light. And indoors, sometimes if you have like, you know, the sunlight flooding in, but with artificial light, it's just not the business. So yeah, for streaming and for YouTube, I highly suggest getting a webcam. I have a comparison of a few different webcams in a separate video, and I'll go ahead and link that. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next review.